Good afternoon, everybody. In this presentation, I'm going to show you the results about a preliminary analysis of a CTM-based receiver for time-of-flight range meters. In particular, I'll show you the effect of cell size on the ambient light rejection. After a brief introduction about detectors in time-of-flight systems, I will show you our experimental setup and measurement results. In the last part of the talk, I'll show you a future step of our study for the indoor optimization, and I'll provide the conclusions of this work. In direct time-of-flight measurement system, the distance of a target is acquired measuring the time delay between the emission of a laser pulse and the detection of the back reflected light. Since timing performances are crucial, detector employed in these systems must be fast and efficient with a high internal gain. That's why avalanche photodiodes are typically used in this kind of systems. Recently, a SPAD array, a Geiger mode avalanche photodiode, have been successfully reported as a receiver in this kind of systems. Many researchers propose to replace the avalanche photodiodes with silicon photomultipliers. These are two studies comparing commercial avalanche photodiodes with silicon photomultipliers. And these studies reveals how CTMs can be successfully used in these systems, showing also better performances. In the last study, we can see in the red curve, in the right, sorry, picture, the LiDAR measurement acquired with the avalanche photodiode, while in the left picture we can see the same measurement acquired with the CTM, so we can see there is a quite good similarity. In the bottom study, we can see in the red curve the output of the CTM compared to the output of the avalanche photodiode, that is the black curve. So CTMs has a improved output signal. So that's not surprising because CTMs have a lot of advantages compared to avalanche photodiode. Among all, their higher gain, lower power consumption, and better uniformity that make them also suitable for portable devices. So the goal of our study is to evaluate the effect of cell size on ambient light rejection. So we analyzed three different CTMs with the same active area but different cell size. CTMs were designed and fabricated at the Fondazione Bruno Kessler. First of all, we have to select a proper overvoltage for the CTMs, and it was done following a trade-off between the photo detection efficiency and dark count rate. As we can see from this graph, reaching a certain voltage, the photo detection efficiency does not more increasing the voltage. While increasing the voltage, we have a higher dark count due to a bigger after pulsing and cross talk. This is our experimental setup. Here we can see the 470 nanometer pulsed laser hitting the target. Then the backscattered light is detected by the CTM receiver, just in front of the receiver, there is an optic used to diffuse the reflected light on the wall active area of the CPM. Time of arrival histograms were acquired with the time correlated single photon counting module, that is a time to digital converter with memory to store the histograms. So the starting signal is given by the sync output of the laser driver, while the stop signal is the output of the CPM. We use a white LED to vary the illuminance of the measurement from a few lux to 1.5 kilolux. The luminance were measured with a commercial lux meter. The output of a single cell of a CPM is a negative pulse as around 10 millivolts. The exact value depends on which CPM we are talking about and which is the overvoltage we provide. The overall output of the CPM is at a given time is the sum of the cells that are triggering at that moment. So the point is how to choose a proper threshold voltage for the TCFPC module. Well, we choose a threshold to detect in their worst case a detection rate of uncorrelated photons lower than 5% of the laser repetition rate. I mean, this value can be reasonably allowed because the final device will acquire the measurement distance performing a data filtering of several measurements acquired. So we can see as the illuminance increase, the detection of the ambient light is first increased because there are more cells that are triggering. Then we reach a saturation point when all the cells in the CPMs are triggering. Then increasing the luminance, the system's lose its linearity. It means that there are more cell firing at that moment, and so the output signal does not exceed the threshold voltage anymore. It can be seen in looking at the screenshot of the oscilloscope as reaching the maximum of the output. If you increase the luminance, the output is lower. Here we can see the probability of detection. At low illuminance level, we have a good sharp signal of the laser detected. While increasing the luminance, the laser detected is lowered in amplitude and it's also broadened. It means that while at low illuminance we have 100% of detection, at higher illuminance we lose the detection. So increasing the luminance, the probability of detection goes to zero. In this case, we can see how both the smallest cell devices shows the better performances. From the time of arrival histograms, we extracted the time precision. We can see how increasing the luminance, the time precision gets worse. Also in this case, both the smaller devices exhibit better performances. Here we can see the average time shift. As the luminance increase, we have seen that the laser detected output is lowered. It means that the voltage threshold crossing time is increased. And that's why increasing the luminance, the average time shift gets worse. In this case, only the 50 micrometer sized CPMs shows the better performance. Indoor lighting with white LEDs show a characteristic spectrum with a blue peak and a broadened yellow component. In the measurement I report so far, we use a 470 nanometer pulsed laser, that is the blue spectrum here. We can see how there is an overlapping between the two spectra. So as future step of our work, we are now developing a driver laser to be used with a commercial 405 nanometer laser diode. We can see how using that laser diodes, the spectrum is the violet spectrum. It means that with a filter just before the optic, we can strongly reduce the effect of ambient light. And moreover, at this wavelength, we have also the maximum of the photo detection efficiency. So not only the ambient light rejection will be increased, but also the laser detection will be increased. In conclusion, let's say the smaller wins, because the 15 micrometer cell devices shows better performances in terms of ambient light rejection, probability of detection, and time precision, showing also a lower average time shift. As future work, we'll extend this comparison of these three CPMs in a range distance measurement performed with the 405 nanometer pulsed laser and a bandpass filter. Thank you for your attention.